Welcome to Maths Classes by Devinder Anand sir. Today we are going to discuss class 8 topic to check out given number is a perfect square or not by another method that is known as continuous subtraction method. Before doing this method, we are going to identify what is the rule for it and how can we apply it. If we see the pattern here, we can understand very well. If you see here, square of 1 is given by 1, square of 2 is given by 4, square of 3 is given by 9, square of 4 is given by 16, square of 5 is given by 25, square of 6 is given by 36, square of 7 is given by 49. If we see these few values, if we see here, 1 can be written as a sum of first odd number, 4 can be written as sum of first two odd numbers, 9 can be written as sum of first three odd numbers, 16 can be written as sum of 4 odd numbers, 25 can be written as sum of 5 odd numbers, 36 can be written as sum of 6 odd numbers, 49 can be written as sum of odd numbers which are in counting 7. What we observe here, square of every number can be written as a sum of a odd number continuous. If you see here, base value tells us how many odd numbers are there. Base is 2, first 2 odd number. Base is 3, first 3 odd number. Base is 4, 4 odd numbers. Base is 5, 5 odd numbers. Base is 6, 6 odd number. Base is 7, 7 odd numbers. So what we observe here, it is a sum of odd numbers. If we go on subtracting the odd numbers continuously, we get it is a perfect square or not. How we check? If we get the answer as a zero number finally, then it is a perfect square. For example, if you see here, for 16, first odd number is 1, then we subtract 3, then we subtract 5, like this, 15, now we subtract 3, 12, now we subtract 5, 7, now we subtract 7, we get 0. If answer comes out 0, it means it is a perfect square. Now, there is a question in the mind. It is a square of which number? If we see here, how many steps it will take? 1 step, 2 step, 3 step, 4 step. It means it is a square of 4. Like this, we can identify it is a square of which number after using continuous subtraction method of odd numbers. Now we are going to start our worksheet number 2 of chapter 1st, Scale and Square Roots. Our question is, find out the square root of the following by using the repeated subtraction method. As we have seen, firstly we write down 16, first we subtract first odd number from the number. Like this, we are doing all of them together here. First of all, we subtract first odd number, then we get the answer of it, like this. From next answer, we subtract next odd number, like this. Next odd number is 3. So here we subtract 3 from here. We get here 96, 60, here we get 45, and here we get 12 from here. Next odd number is 5. We get from here 7, next odd number is 7, we get 0, we get 40, next odd number is 7, difference become 33, next odd number is 9, difference become 24, next odd number is 11, we get 13, next odd number is our 13, we get here 0. It means it is a perfect square, it is also a perfect square. Here, if you see 60 minus 5, 55, 55 minus 7, 48, 48 minus 9, 39, 39 minus 11, it become 28, 28 minus next odd number 13, 15, 15 minus next odd number 15, it becomes 0. Here, 96 minus next odd number 5, 91, 91 minus 7, 84, 84 minus 9, 75, 75 minus 11, 64, 64 minus 13, 51. 51 minus 15, 36. 36 minus 17, that is 19. 19 minus 19, 19 minus 19 become 0. Now, how can we see here? It is a scale of which number? If you see here, 1, 2, 3, 4 steps. So, it becomes scale of 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, it is a scale of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It is a scale of 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, it is a scale of 10. Like this, we can represent them by using continuous subtraction of odd number. It is a scale of which number? Now, our question is, find out the square root of the following number. What is the meaning of square root? Square means power 2. Root means remove the power. So, here the symbol for square root is given by this one. Square root of 16 is given by remove the power 4. Square root of 49, remove the power 7. Square root of 64 is given by 8. Square root of 100 is given by remove the power, it becomes 10. Like this, we can find out the square root of the following number by using repeated subtraction method. Now we are going to continue with next. 169 minus 1, 168, 168 minus 3, 165 minus 5, 160 minus 7, 153 minus 9, 144 minus 11, 133 minus 13, 120 minus 15, 105 minus 17, it become from here 88 minus 19, it become from here 69 minus 21, we get from here 48 minus 23, we get from here 25 minus 25 become 0. So it is a perfect square of which number? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. It is a square of 13. So square root of 169 comes out 13. Now 81. 81 minus 1. 80. 80 minus 3. 77. 77 minus 5. 72. 72 minus 7. 65. 65 minus 9, 56. 56 minus 11, 45. 45 minus 13, 32. 32 minus 15, that is 17. 17 minus 17, 0. How many steps are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So it is a square of 9. So square root of 81 become, remove the power, answer is 9. If we continue with here, 144 minus 1, 143 minus 3, 140, 140 minus 5, 135, 135 minus 7, 128, 128 minus 9, 119, 119 minus 11, 108, 108 minus 13, 95, 95 minus 15, it become 80. 80 minus 17, it becomes 63. 63 minus 19, it become 44. 44 minus 21, it become 23. And 23 minus 23 become 0. So how many steps it will take here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So it is a scale of 12. So the square root of this value, 144, it is given by 12. Now, for 256, 256 minus 1, 255. 255 minus 3, 252. 252 minus 5, 247. 247 minus 7, 240. 240 minus 9, 2, 3, 1 minus 11, 2, 2, 0. 2, 2, 0 minus 13, 2, 0, 7. 2, 0, 7 minus 15, 192. 192 minus 17, it become 175. 175 minus 19, it become 156. 156 minus 21, we get from here 135. 135 minus 23, we get from here 112. 112 minus 25, we get from here 87. 87 minus 27, we get from here 60. 60 minus 29, we get from here 31. 31 minus 31, we get here 0. How many steps it will take? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. It is a square of 16. So square root of 256, it comes out 16. So like this, we can find out the square root of the following number by using repeated subtraction method.